What's up, Creed? Coach Andrew, Coach Maddie, coming at you with your Monday workout, starting the week fresh here. We're going to have a part A and a part B, a couple AMRAPs with the strength portion, and we're going to have a nice finisher for the core as well, and we're going to start off, as usual, with a nice warm-up. So part A, we have two movements here, four sets in 8 minutes, so obviously we're looking at 2 minutes per set, utilize our whole 8 minute clock here, going with 10 and 10, a dumbbell seesaw floor press here. So that seesaw movement has been more common these past couple weeks. So it's that similar idea, holding two dumbbells here. We're gonna extend up to the top. As one comes down, the other goes up. All right, it's kind of like an elevator. One goes up, one goes down. And we're making sure our elbows are at 45 degrees, making sure that dumbbell stays near the shoulder at the bottom. And then we press up, comes over the chest, you're gonna squeeze the chest and tricep there. Going 10 reps on the right arm, 10 reps on the left arm. If you have two dumbbells, that's what we're doing. If you have one dumbbell, obviously you'll just do one arm for 10 reps and the other arm for 10 reps as well. Then we have 30 dumbbell hollow hold flutter kicks. So we're holding that dumbbell over our chest and face area in the hollow hold position. Core is tucked in, ribcage down. We want that ribcage flared out. So make sure that low back is flush with the floor. And we are fluttering our feet just a few inches past our heel and a few inches past our toe each time. We don't want big kicks. No scissor kicks here, just small flutter kicks. And we're going 15 each leg for a total of 30. We have four sets there in part A. Part B now, we have an AMRAP for 5 minutes. So what that's gonna look like is we have hang power cleans for our first movement. We're gonna alternate each rep here. We have in the left hand, bow to the knee. So making sure that shoulder stays over our wrist as we bow forward. We don't just wanna squat down and keep our chest up. So bring those shoulders over wrists and then drive those hips. Big jump, shrug, and front rack catch with those soft knees, all right? I believe we have 6 reps there. Yes, 6, 12, 18. So then we have 12 alternating V-ups. So we're going down to the ground in our hollow hold position is how we start, hands overhead, and we're throwing that leg up to our hands, creating a nice V with our torso and our leg here. All right, we're also gonna start that movement by throwing our arms first and then bringing our leg up to meet at the center. Then we have 18 double unders, sorry, it's behind the board here. 18 double unders or 54 single unders here. So on the lower end of reps, we're going for some fast reps here. A good day to practice double unders if we are not efficient just yet. Hopefully you can still hear. Then we're going to have a 1 minute rest after that 5 minute AMRAP. Then we're going to a 4 minute AMRAP of the exact same movements, but now we have 4 reps on hang cleans, 8 reps on alternating V-ups, and I believe, let's see, that was 18, so it goes down to 12. Double unders or 36 single unders. All right, so similar AMRAPs, a little bit less time, and a little bit less reps on the next portion, all right? Monday's finisher will be a core finisher. We're gonna have a increasing rep scheme with that one, so it's gonna get challenging the more we go on, which will be fun. But as always, we're gonna start off with a warm up here. We got a 1 minute cardio choice into a 4 minute AMRAP, 16 jumping jacks, 6 air squats, 16 slow alternate shoulder taps, and 6 sit-ups. We'll get our timer set up here, 5 minutes on the clock, and we'll get rolling in 10. Starting off with a minute of cardio. Six air squats, getting nice and deep here, warming those hips up. Whew. jumping jacks, we make our way back down. Arm here. Just like a lever system. All right, we're moving both arms at the same time. Just a little bit of coordination here. We don't want to see any stiff arms, so we're going down, down, back up, back up. Just imagine it's just like a seesaw. Your hands are connected. One goes down, the other goes up. One goes down, the other goes up. We are 10 and 10. We go straight into our floater kicks. So it's that hollow hold position, dumbbell over chest, we'll kick it 30 times. There you go. It's about a minute per set here. So just as any strength portion, we'll have about 30 seconds of rest, and we're still looking to increase weight every set here. So if you have heavier dumbbells at home, we can increase that weight every set, or if we don't have any options for heavier dumbbells, we can slow the tempo down. So slower reps on the seesaw row and slower reps with our flutter kicks. More control also will increase that intensity for us if we don't have the option for heavier weights. About 30 seconds to rest. We give ourselves about 15 seconds more. Hopefully you enjoyed the weekend. If you joined us for Fall Brawl, we hope you guys had a great time. We are sure looking forward to it, because that'll be tomorrow for us, but this will will be, what, 2 days ago for y'all when I'm seeing this, so.
Yeah.
Hopefully, praying for no injuries, everybody has a good time. Everybody stay safe. We all,
have a day of the old time.
Have a day of the old time. Yeah. All right, guys, going into our set two here, set two. Like I said, slow that set low down, just a little bit here, slow on the way down. So our flutter kicks here. Just like that. By slowing down the time, we add about 15, 20 seconds onto it. It's made it a little bit better for us. Time under tension is key. Train strength. The slower, the better. Go slow, go low, and you'll grow.
Look at that. Did you come up with that?
Not really, no. I'm just gonna, it's over time. Take some seconds. Go slow to grow. Go slow to grow. There we go. Of course, that's about 20 more seconds here. Shake those arms out. Like I said, if that last set felt pretty good, you do have the option with heavier dumbbells at home. Try a little bit more, see how we can do. We have a full 8 minutes, we're at our halfway point, 4 more minutes left, no rush here. All right, that's what part B is for, that's when we start rushing a little bit. And those AMRAPs, so we'll rest time there and there. So, go ahead and hop back into our floor press. Third set here. Slower and slower each round. Kind of the idea right there. Only have 30 seconds left this time, so we're looking good on time. Good on time.
Ooh. Need some new shoes in a little bit.
Oh, man.
Starting to rip. Anybody have any shoe suggestions? Good running shoe suggestions? Hit me up.
Those are great shoes.
Yeah, they're a little old now, about a year, a little over a year old now. So.
Yeah.
Could use some new ones. You guys, going into our last set here. Oh, make sure you get tendons in each arm. Go slow and control in each direction, up and down. Thank you. You got about 45 seconds left.
We did.
Very good on time right there. So we will take these 45 seconds. We'll refresh ourselves on part B. Continue on through if you haven't gotten that fourth set in yet. If you have and you're ready to go for part B, you can skip ahead and we'll be there in about 30 seconds. So part B, it starts with an AMRAP of 5 minutes. Like I said, we're starting off with 6 dumbbell hang power cleans into 12 alternating V-ups, and then finishing with 18 double unders or 54 single unders. And we have ourselves a minute of rest after that. And we'll go over the second AMRAP with you guys during that minute. Alternating V-ups for one leg at a time. There we go. Once we get 6 and 6 each leg, going into our doubles and singles here. 54 single unders or 18 double unders. Like I said, if you can string 5 or 6 double unders together at a time, today would be a great day to practice those. Back to the top. Yeah. 90 seconds. 3 and 3 each arm here. Make sure we're hinging forward. Those hips stay on the same plane. We're just pushing them back, 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 back. And have a slight knee bend. Once the hand reaches the knee, we're driving up with flat feet, hips through the dumbbell, nice upright row and shrug into a catch. Thank you. some med ball there.
Remember our movements, so to say, that our reps change. So, I'm showing to you my own handwriting. We have 4 hang power cleans instead of 6. We have 8 V ups. And we have 12 double unders or 30 single unders. 36 single unders. I'm really struggling to read my own handwriting.
I don't know how to do 36.
It's not much.
Whoa.
Or?
Just, I was doing like when you're talking about 4, 8, 12, and I was like 36. I was like, 36. Are you able to tell?
This is 6.
Really?
Yeah, 6, 7, 8.
Look at her. She's bilingual with like with sign language.
All right, guys, here you go.
Going to each side here with our hand cleans now. Going 4 each leg here. Once we get 8, we're right back up. We're going to stay explosive here, hip hinge back, and explode through as if we were jumping straight through the ceiling. Not jumping backwards, jumping straight up. Last 15 seconds.
Nice work.
There we go.
But we are not done yet.
Never done. 13. We're going 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. All the way up until we get to 4 minutes. So you could end with 32 maybe. Who knows? But we have two movements that we're doing with both of those rep schemes. We're going Superman's first, so we're on our belly. We're in the whole posterior chain here, back of the shoulders, back, glutes, hamstrings. Basically, the only thing we're trying to leave on the floor is the upper part of our thigh, hips, and lower part of our rib cage on the ground. Everything else should be coming off the ground, trying to make it a reverse hollow hold, if you will. So, Superman, two reps, we'll squeeze, relax, and then we'll flip it on over into our Russian twists. Feet in the air here, feet in the air. Start with two reps. We're gonna go hard count here today. So basically, every other side will be one rep. All right, so that will get hard pretty quick here. So, 4 minutes is on the clock. We'll get it rolling. Mark makes the dream work. There we go. Beautiful.
10 seconds.
10 seconds. Start with two reps. Here we go. Roll it over into our Russian twist. Back to our Supermans. Going four reps now. Four reps. On to number 8, and we're just over a minute in. Man, facing the ground gets me dripping. To double digits here, uncharted territory.
Fifteen.